Applause for Cecil Country Boy Coffee. A nice round of applause for that young man.
What a fight, and it all came down to the sixth round. Here's another look at it.
This is what you call, Bruce, of turning the left hook over. Straight on the chin. Wop.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the...
When we come back, we'll have an opportunity to talk to the fighters. They'll put on a very impressive show tonight at the Showboat. You're watching professional boxing from Atlantic City.
The number one fitness exercise in the world is cross-country skiing, and now it can be duplicated.
The Showboat in Atlantic City, and just moments ago, Seamus McDonough stopping Cecil Coffey at 2:59 of the sixth round, and Cecil Coffey joins us along with Murphy Griffith. And first of all, Cecil, your thoughts on the bout?
Well, I take my hat off to the guy. You know, he caught me with a good left hook. I was winning the fight, obviously, with my left hand, but I think the inactivity, I've been off a long time, and it caught up with me. I got caught with a good left hook. Maybe if I'd been more active and I was used to seeing those punches, maybe I wouldn't have got caught, but no excuses.
Was there a headbutt involved?
I'm not saying there was. There might have been. We was fighting in close pretty much, and I don't know, you know.
Murphy, his jab was very sharp tonight.
Yeah, well, the jab that he was throwing tonight was good, but the one thing he should have stayed with was the double jab, which was more effective, because every time you double jab on the guy, you break him up, you know?
And obviously,
I think he got a little over-anxious where he wanted to...
He saw
the guy, he can hit him with a jab easy. He tried to take him out, and that was a mistake. The guy came back with a good left hook, and he caught him.
Inactivity certainly hurt me, but I don't give any excuses, you know. He's a good puncher.
What about your shape right now? Do you feel confident in what you've accomplished working with Murphy?
I'm in shape. I've worked hard, you know. I mean, I was not tired whatsoever. I could have went probably 12 or 15, but I just got caught.
Yeah. Buddy, your thoughts on his performance?
I'd like to congratulate Mr. Cecil Coffey on a very good fight. I thought his jab was very well, and surprising with the body work that he also established in the fight.
All right, Murphy, what's next?
Well, we're going to take a little break, and he'll be back.
I just got to get some more sparring and get my timing and stuff back together. You know, I've been off a long time, 9 months.
Yeah.
I ain't been in the ring, and 6 months before that, so... You know, it's got to take an effect on a guy. I'm sure Buddy knows that. He's a fighter himself. But no excuses. This man is a better man tonight.
All right. Gutsy effort. Good luck to you.
Thanks a lot. Okay. Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, so Cecil Coffey losing to Seamus McDonough. When we come back, we'll hear from the winner right here at the Showboat. We'll return with more. You're watching professional boxing from Atlantic City. Moments ago, Seamus McDonough stopped Cecil Coffey at 2:59 of the sixth to improve his record to 17-1-1 with his 13th knockout. And Seamus McDonough and Nick Baffey join us right now. Seamus, it was a big punch, but you took a pretty good punch at the same time. Tell us about it.
Well, the way it worked out, I thought I was going to knock him out early. Then I saw he was stronger than I thought he was. So, I laid back a while. I think I laid back a little too much, though, I find out now. But then I was patient, I waited, and then when I caught him, I finished him pretty well.
When you ended the fight with your left hook, you took a pretty good left hook. Did you feel it?
In the heat of the action, you don't feel them. You don't feel them, unless you're on the cameras, of course. But
how do you feel about your strength as a heavyweight at 202 pounds?
I felt strong, really strong. It was a big step up for me. He's the most experienced guy I've fought, 19-1. But I thought I did pretty good.
All right, James, let's go back and pick up the first knockdown in the sixth round and give you a chance to take a look at it. Tell us what you're thinking and tell us what you're doing here.
Well, I knew I'd wasted a lot of the round, but I caught him with that good left hook. When he went down, I didn't think he was going to get up from it, actually, because it was a really good left hook.
And then just moments later, you finished him off. You knew that you had him in trouble, and you went after him.
Yeah, and I heard that dong go for the last 10 seconds. I said, I got to get this guy now, or it's going to be another round.
Here's a look at the ending. And Nick Baffey, why don't you take a look at this ending with us and tell us what was going through your mind?
Well, I know once Seamus had him down, he's a good finisher, and I know the guy wasn't going to last. He would have got knocked out the next round, guaranteed.
There's the ending. Finally, Steve Smoger will jump in and end this fight just 1 second before the bell to end the sixth round. Nick, I thought the key word in this fight for Seamus McDonough, and Buddy McGirt pretty much mentioned it most of the evening, was patience.
Yes, I think that Seamus showed tonight that he's a legitimate heavyweight and a force to be reckoned with in the heavyweight division.
What about your thoughts, Nick, on the patience factor?
Well, he started fast, and he started a little too fast. Then he settled down, we settled him down, and he followed instructions. And he just took his time, and he knew he can belt even in the 10th round.
I think the instructions he's talking about is the jab. We heard him go into the corner about the second round and said, Sheamus, you got to throw the jab.
Yeah, I was just like slipping a lot of his punches, but not countering. So that isn't very good. So I started to counter then. I started to get my range a little better.
What does this mean to you now, being able to handle a full-blown heavyweight, a guy who has been in the likes with a Jose Ribalta and a Terry Armstrong?
Well, actually, I've known it for a while. You just had to prove it to everybody else, though. So it'll add to my confidence more and the experience, and it'll make me a better fighter.
You were counterpunching tonight more than we've seen you in a while. Was that a conscious plan?
Well, we've been working on the counterpunching for a while because I'm a very aggressive fighter, and I just wanted to work on the counterpunching to build that up also to become a complete fighter.
Nick, does anybody scare you?
Not with Sheamus. Nobody.
What are you going to look for next?
Well, we see what Bobby comes up with. We got a chance for the cruiserweight title in France with Baboulou, some guy from France. We're thinking that over.
Sheamus McDonough on a super fight tonight.
Thank you, Bruce.
Sheamus McDonough victorious at the show with the knockout in the sixth round. And here's another look at that finishing sixth. McDonough with the left hook. And then after Smoger had allowed the two fighters to start again, Sheamus finished them for good. We'll be back with much more in just a moment. You're watching professional boxing from Atlantic City. Casino in Atlantic City, the Boardwalk's Big Easy, where tonight Sheamus McDonough victorious over Cecil Coffey with a sixth round TKO. And there's a look at the Showboat, the newest hotel casino in Atlantic City. We hope you enjoyed tonight's professional boxing. One more look at Sheamus McDonough as he stops Cecil Coffey and records his 13th knockout of his career. For James Buddy McGirt, I'm Bruce Beck. Fight Night has been a presentation of Madison Square Garden Boxing and the Showboat Hotel and Casino. So long from the Showboat in Atlantic City.